Good morning, Althea. You guys are starting to learn. I'm beginning on time. We're honoring the sacred. Thank you. Welcome to this beautiful sacred center on sacred land that's over 100 years old, created by three powerful women of divine science. And I'd like to welcome you all, and those that are on their way, if they can hear me in the hallway, please gently silence your cell phones, or better yet, turn them off and give yourself some space from texting. The Broncos do not start till, what is it, 1:30, 2:30, something like that. So there's no reason to check for the game. I'd like to thank everyone for watching online on Facebook and YouTube. Welcome. Feel free to place your comments or prayers into the chat line. And as I said earlier, we're going to acknowledge the land here. This land rests on indigenous, powerful, holy land of the Cheyenne, Arapaho, and Ute nations. And their legacy is very important. And Althea is just more than just talk. We have two nonprofits that we support that are part of that. They're Spirit of the Sun and Sisters of Color United in Education. And we give them a discount for being in this building as we share in light and love and harmony and healing of this indigenous land. And our affirmation of diversity. When I first came here, one of the things I loved, I felt so welcome here as a black woman. And one of the board members said, we know we have not worked on diversity. I will say, you guys are working on diversity. And I'm not saying that because I am here. I'm seeing it in the crowd, and I'm seeing it online. You are practicing what you're preaching, and thank you. Althea affirms that we are a community of diversity speaking seekers. We are growing in diversity in race, gender, and sexual orientation, age, ethnicity as well, backgrounds, and physical abilities. We're evolving consciousness, moving beyond differences and dichotomies to embrace oneness, unity, and community. We are ever more aware of the past atrocities and the present biases in our nation and in our world. And Althea is committed to be an open and a safe place for seekers of all religions, all faiths, all denominations, for we practice what we are, and that is oneness. So now I'd like to invite those that aren't too shy to raise your hand if you're a first time, and we have a small gift for you. Welcome. Welcome. Thank you. And I like to, for me, I have to do it because I'm going to cry if I don't, recognize a dear friend, Dr. David Goldberg, who is an amazing soul, amazing minister, amazing teacher. Thank you for being here. Thank you. And now our opening prayer from Shauna Perry.
Good morning, everyone. It's good to see everybody. Usually I freestyle, but my little one's going through like some sleep regression and teething, and mommy brain is a real thing, so I wrote this out last night. So let us take a moment to land and connect within. If it helps to close your eyes, you can do that. If you want to drift your gaze, that's fine too. Let's connect with the sacred space, this beautiful community that nourishes our hearts and spirits each week. Let us begin to quiet the mind and connect with our breath. As you breathe in, notice your body expanding. And as you breathe out, allow your body to soften. Take a moment to be with the softness. Place your attention on your chest and imagine a golden yellow light radiating around your heart space. Sense the connection to this transition into autumn. The energy of autumn is about creative expression, introspection, and harvesting. This season before us is offering a prime moment to pause and to celebrate the balance of light and dark. Together, let's place our hands on our hearts and honor our light within that shines brightly as an expression of the divine. Let us also take some time to pay attention to our humanness and our capacity for the dark. Allow any thoughts and emotions that are no longer nourishing or serving us to come to our awareness. And let's hold them here with love and compassion. And then, like the turning of the leaves, we'll allow them to fall away. Together in unison, we express deep and profound gratitude for our connection with Source and nature. We recognize the gifts that we are offered through our lives and the experience of the cycles and the seasons. We acknowledge and trust the lessons that each cycle holds. With love, we are connected in harmony to divine creation. And so it is. Amen.
Good morning and welcome. I'd like to invite you all to stand if you're able and join me in the statement of being. God is all, both invisible and visible. One presence, one mind, one power is all. This one that is all is perfect life, perfect love, and perfect substance. We are individualized persons of God and are ever one with this perfect life, perfect love, and perfect substance. Now, if you join me in singing, "You Are the Face of God."
You are the face of God. I hold you in my heart. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of love. I hold you in my heart. We are a family. We are the face of God.
Thank you. Today's featured musician, you may sit if you'd like. Today's featured musician is Allison Keller. She is a professional soloist, percussionist, voice coach, and sex educator and coach. She graduated in December 2022 from Colorado State University with a BS in psychology and a BA in ethnic studies, and has since started her own business called Sextraordinary Coaching as a member of the Mosaic Gospel Choir and Zimbira Afrofusion Band. She keeps herself busy with music. Allison loves to hike, socialize, knit, and enjoys various types of music in her free time. Let's all give a round of applause to Allison Keller.
Song when you have sung it for so long, and how can you forget your dance when that dance is all you ever had? It must be true. You can't separate the two. Oh, no, you can't. It's impossible to do, just like the salt in the stew. Oh, my, it's all a part of you. Yeah, one thing that life cannot do. Life can't do it, no. It can't take your soul from you. So when life brings a chance for you to give your part away, don't just stand there feeling scared. Don't be afraid, 'cause there could be a treasure right there. Now listen to the truth. It does not matter, doesn't matter what you do. It's still gonna be you, just like the salt in the stew. Hey, yeah. It's all a part of you, and one thing that a life cannot do. Hey, you can't do it, no. It can't take your soul from you. Don't give it. Life can't take it. Oh, 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 yeah. Can't take your salt from you.
I'm going to call up my extra musician. This is going to be Nature Boy. Oh, is that the next section? Never mind. That'll come later.
could listen to you all day, though. That would be awesome. Round of applause for Allison. Thank you. All right. And now the reading. For the reading today, I ask for you to contemplate these powerful, powerful words. The first one is by William Walker Atkinson. Yes. The superconscious. There is always the impression and idea of the flashes of thought or feeling coming from above, either from some higher part of one's own mind, the mind of some higher being, or the universal kind. Universal mind is probably what we meant. The storehouse of the impressions of the past, as in the subconscious, the superconsciousness of the individual is the latent possibilities of the future man or Superman. The superconsciousness is the consciousness of the future individuals of the race, and in it are stored the latent faculties and mental activities of a higher race of beings. William Walker Atkinson, written in 1909. This next one's by Edgar Cayce. So may an individual effect a healing through meditation, through attuning not just a side of the mind or a portion of the body, but the whole, to that at oneness with the spiritual forces within, the gift of the life force within each body. Each individual body must bring its own creative force in balance. By Edgar Cayce. And now it is my honor to present or reintroduce to you our spiritual director, Reverend Christina, who you have already seen up here on stage if you are new. She is a religious science CSL minister, certified personal development coach, inspirational speaker, dietitian, and author. She is the founder and creator of DivineFeminineEvolution.org, a new CSL affiliated focus ministry, celebrating the divine feminine in all of us. Reverend Christina has been active in the New Thought, New Age movement since childhood. Seven generations of powerful ancestors in her lineage have passed on metaphysical and spiritual principles from her family traditions. She celebrates life with her husband and thrives in the magical mountains of Colorado. Christina is a healing emissary of light for herself and the world. And here she is.
Thank you, Luis. Good morning again. I have to bring a phone up to keep time. As a minister, we are born with the gift of gab. We'll be here all day, so that's why the phone goes up. So this month, I chose to speak on origins, going way back to consciousness. And if any of you saw the email of the superhero, I believe we're all superheroes. So today is on super consciousness. We started with consciousness being aware. And then following week, I spoke of unconscious. Like woke, we're really not woke. And watching the terms we use to be aware, to be present, to manifest peace, harmony for ourselves and for the world. Because everything is an inside job. Then Melinda was here, my dear friend, amazing woman. She actually does the work of subconscious beliefs. And subconscious beliefs actually causes some interesting habits sometimes. And they're not our own. Sometimes it's given by our childhood of rewiring. Something like Joe Dispenza talks about that. Those are subconscious beliefs. We're going to finish up with super consciousness. Now, I personally feel there's many levels of consciousness. I think there's more than seven. You start reading, you could really go down the rabbit hole on that one. However, the superconscious The great I am, we are. I heard that when I was 10. And I asked my mom what that meant. As a little girl growing up in New Orleans, and a mom who was metaphysical, she was metaphysical but also Catholic. Dad was Methodist and a Rosicrucian. So I had all these different worlds going on at the same time. And my mom would hide books from me. And I never understood why. They were all on sacred geometry and drawings and old Egyptian texts. And I would try to find these books. But I would have these weird dreams and sometimes panic attacks. I'm little, I didn't understand what was going on. Later she said, you were opening up pathways and you're not ready for it. And I was really angry, I was really ticked off. Like, what do you mean I'm not ready for it? Are you kidding me? But I grew up with this. My mom, when she was carrying me, had all these past life dreams. And one of the reasons I love Edgar Casey, that was one of the readings, my dad's best friend worked in the government and said, whoever is coming has a message and you are to help her with it. When she started to read Edgar Casey books, and went into Unity books and all of these teachings, it helped her get grounded and me. That's super consciousness. I believe when all of us meditate, it elevates intuition. Super consciousness is intuition. Excuse me, messing with the mic. It is intuition, clairaudience, clairvoyance. There's way more than this. Channeling, knowing things that sometimes you think you shouldn't know, or even walking into a building like this one and you feel an energy field. Or have you ever walked into a house and you're like, I don't know about this house. It's kind of like the horror movies when they say, get out. Yeah, you start running. That's your intuition. That's super consciousness. So I see clients as a minister and as a coach. And someone asked me, how do you pray for peace? I said, well, you got to become peace. But the one thing this person told me, and this individual is so powerful, because of her old beliefs, she's still afraid of her Christianity beliefs. Because in some religions, if you say you're an intuitive, or you say you're connected, or you might get a hit on something, in some religions, they tell you that's dark, or it's wrong, or you shouldn't. We are all born intuitive, trust. There's different levels of it. We've all had hunches. Don't park there, don't go there. The middle of this month, anniversary of 9/11, you know how many people didn't go to work that day because it didn't feel right, or they called out sick? That's that. That's super consciousness. That's who we are. And that's what these teachings are. When Luis introduced me, religious science is from divine science. But when you go back there, it's actually from Hinduism and probably from another planet. Because it is about oneness. Spirit has created us in his, her, ether likeness. Whatever you call God is neither male or female. It, that energy, that great is unattached. So I feel it's time that all of us, and that's me included, I was told to keep my mouth shut. Because as a little girl, I knew when someone was going to pass away. That was hard. Don't talk about that. So even though it sounds like my parents were open, there was still some fear, and there was ancestral fear. I lived in New Orleans. Trust, there was ancestral fear. And then later finding out I'm a distant cousin of Marie Laveau. And the media made her look bad, that she did this and she did that. Well, they also did that to the founders of New Thought. I've been doing research on divine science, how they were ministers when the stage was designed different, that was attacked because they were speaking what you would call prophecy And this is early 1900s, oh boy. Now it's becoming more commonplace. And in order to get to that faculty, it is meditation and prayer. I know a lot of people like, I can't meditate, I can't sit still. You gotta try, even 5 minutes. Be still and know is in the scripture. There's a reason for that. If you really look at scripture, and even though some people get triggered by it, it is metaphysical. The Old Testament is actually Hebrew scripture. The Kabbalah believes in the super conscious. I even believe there's a supra conscious. I know someone that can bend spoons. There's no trick in it. Kind of like the Matrix. Was my mind bending, or was he really bending the spoon? I believe we are superheroes. I even believe Hollywood's given us hints. We started watching Avatar. Yes, I'm late watching the second Avatar, but it's 3 hours. There's no way I was doing that in the movie theater. Gotta do it at home. It's metaphysical. Look at Doctor Strange. When he is drawing out his sacred geometry and he's opening up portals, what's the possibility? The indigenous people, what I know of the Houma Indians, which is from Louisiana, and I grew up around that energy, they believed in opening up portals of healing and land and prayer to divert hurricanes. My entire life living in New Orleans, I never saw a hurricane. That was amazing when I heard all the stories. And you know, when every time a hurricane was headed, I'm not saying the town or the state did anything, but they would go into prayer. And I mean, my mother dragged me to an ancient Catholic church that was huge, and we were up till 1 a.m. with novena candles praying to dissipate a hurricane. I'm telling you, it worked. Something happened and something shifted. Now, I don't know if we could pray away every earthquake and everything that happened in Libya. We can't say, well, how come they're not praying this? Some things have to happen. And we may not know that in this physical plane. But that super consciousness, that is us. And that's Christ consciousness. That's Bodhi consciousness. That's the Bodhisattva. That's Kuan Yin. It's whatever you want to call it, the I am, the is. To go within and listen. And sometimes you get it when you're driving down a road. I've heard a voice that said, move over now. And a huge red truck was going like 90. And I just cried and said, thank you. And then when I thought about it and shared this story with a mentor, Dr. Lord Berry, an amazing man, said, it's because, Christina, you listened. How many times we don't listen to that little voice, that first mind? And like I said, there are times that, even though I'm in these teachings, like, I don't want to meditate this morning. I'm cranky. COVID happened. That was weird. It was like, I even felt a frequency was going on with the shutdown. Like, what is going on? And even a couple of times, I had a hard time sitting still because I found myself getting bombarded by the news, information, and texts, and panic. And then day three, I'm like, I gotta go sit down. I felt jarred. But then I thought about it. I'm like, I'm stuck in this unconscious for a moment. I'm stuck in a program that's a different consciousness. I need to get myself higher. You know, there's really no such thing as hell and heaven. It's only states of consciousness. You could sit next to someone in a plane and they are in total bliss and the other person is ready to pick a fight. Who is in heaven and who is in hell? It is a state of consciousness. You notice when you see a movie or you go to a comedy club and you just fall out laughing, don't you feel lighter? You feel joyful. Well, we manifest from the super consciousness. So when you consciously say, you know what, I'm off, I might just chant a prayer or get myself grounded. Sometimes I just say, Om Namah Shivaya. And I'm driving because I could just feel some energies around me. And there's a peace. Just tapping in that one moment. Florin Schoeffel Shinn, powerful woman. Visualizing is a mental process governed by the reasoning or conscious mind. Visioning is a spiritual process governed by intuition or the super conscious. That was written in the early 1900s. I've been finding writings from 1700s speaking on it, of the super conscious mind. We are in a time right now, started September 15th to October 15th, it's Hispanic month. And I started thinking about the Basilica in Mexico City. That was super consciousness going on there. When Diego had many premonitions and visitations from Our Lady Guadalupe, some people would call the Virgin Mary or the Black Madonna. And her vision being in his coat that now hangs in that church that was started in the 1500s by a group of monks. And they did think he was crazy. They said, you can't get visitations from Guadalupe, from the grandmother. There was healings. There's still healings going on. And that garment has never faded. That's super consciousness. Now, I feel he was visualizing. He didn't know the words for it at the time when the Pope said, we're not building a church here, and they didn't believe him. He believed it, and hundreds of people supported him. And that basilica still stands despite all the earthquakes. It is a beautiful, beautiful place of holy energy. And then they may not have used a word such as visualizing and visioning at the time, but there was something running that we could call it intuition. We're talking the 1500s. That is amazing. So that energy still exists no matter what. Every culture has a name for it. A friend of me and my husband's is amazing professor of Nordic studies, and I asked him yesterday, do the Norwegians and the Vikings have a word for higher consciousness, superconscious? And he said it's hug. Hug. He said it's a different concept, but he said if you're talking about going to a different realm, when they were, say, wanting to connect with their gods, Odin, or wanting to know what needs to be done, it's called hug. So realizing there are so many cultures that have a term for super consciousness. As I say this to you, I say this to me, there's time for me to work on my own. I know for me, it's very easy for me to help other people. Someone calls me, I'm there. Free or a coaching client, doesn't matter, I'm there. I'm giving them books, telling them books, and all this other stuff. And I was like, you know what? I'm still holding back on my intuition. That's hit me 2 weeks ago. I'm like, oh, here's something. I'm like, I'm making that up. No. The unconscious comes in, I'm making that up. Or, boy, if I tell my girlfriend this, she's going to think I'm nuts. And I took a chance and say, hey, I'm getting this about what's shifting on the planet. And she said, oh, I'm getting that too. I was afraid to tell you as well. And I'm like, okay, there's that one mind. Time for me to practice what I preach. And also, maybe I mind my own super consciousness business. One thing I'm really aware of, many of us want to help others, but then sometimes we got to take a step back and look at our own consciousness. Now, yes, I'm saying this while on stage as a minister. And yes, we're going to do workshops. Let those come. When I think about the great Wayshore, Jesus did not force, Buddha did not force, Brahma, the Hindu god, did not force into making you teach, learn, and follow. There is no forcing. That's the ego that wants the force. The ego wants to tell you to tell other people to go do X, Y, and Z. No, we got enough of that on this planet, don't you think? Of everyone telling us how to be, how to dress, what to do, what to say. No, no, we got enough of that. It's time to move forward and live long and prosper. Yes, I'm a Trekkie. And I've known this for some time, but now there's more information coming out about the wonderful Leonard Nimoy, because this was his idea when he auditioned for Star Trek. And it's from Kabbalism, that the high priest would do that as a blessing for everyone in the room. And they did it in the shape of a pyramid, and it is in Egypt everywhere. I saw this symbol in Peru at Machu Picchu. That's a mudra. Now, the mudras change your state of consciousness, like when you hold, when you do a om. Well, that's a mudra. It helps rewire your brain for prosperity and spirituality and abundance. Isn't that amazing? And we've been seeing it for years. Little kids doing it. Well, hey, try. I used to be able to do it with both hands. I got to work on that again. But it is time for us to live long and prosper and be in that superhero mindset. Because we can create and do great things. Think about, you might open up a door for someone one day, just at a grocery store, hold a door. They might be having a bad day. You just don't know. A smile might change their mind. Asking someone really, how are you today? And not just walking away, like really engaging, looking in their eyes and saying, how are you? I want to hear. And taking that moment to listen. Calling a friend when you feel, wow, you've been on my mind. You've had that happen. And you try to call each other at the same time. Well, there may be something going on, maybe with you, maybe with them, or something. That's super consciousness. That's where we're moving to. And I believe Gaia is as well. With every grand shift in consciousness and evolution, the planets change, the earth change every time. So it's not a coincidence. With a lot of the earthquakes and floodings and fires and all the interesting things, our life is a blink of an eye. It's been going on for millions of years. We are superheroes. We can shift. And as I say that, it's just not a platitude. I did. Over 10 years ago, I was in a very interesting marriage that almost killed me. I didn't listen to my intuition. And one night I was so scared I wouldn't wake up. I kept thinking my mother and my aunt are going to die if he kills me. And I felt the sense of being paralyzed. And I found myself going back and saying the Lord's Prayer. And a voice said, move now. It was not my voice. It was a booming voice. Go downstairs and look at the safe. I got rid of the gun, took the gun safe out, and found a life insurance policy that was forged in my name for $1 million, something happened to me. This individual was planning on killing me. I came back to bed and I was calm. He's still in the bed, and there was a pop and a purple light. You may think, people in my mind may think, well, this woman's really nuts. My mom, when I told her the story, she thinks it was Archangel Michael. Because she said, I felt you, and I didn't know what to do. I didn't know whether to call the police. You didn't call me. It's in the middle of the night. I didn't know, and I had to trust. But that it was a purple light that went through the walls, and he ran out of the house and said, someone's messing with me. You people from New Orleans are messing with me. In that moment, I started going back to Mile High Church. In that moment, I started reading my books again. In that moment, my super consciousness that I allow saved my life. It's time for all of us to do that. Don't wait for the spiritual 2x4. It hurts. And it can be quite scary sometimes. So be happy. Be prosperous. No matter what we will see, as I know we're all feeling things on the planet, we hear things in politics, stand firm and strong. Because your prayer and your meditation is your breath. And we're going to do a small little 2-3 minute just silence. So it's time for us to really trust. In this time of technology, we have so much information available to us. It's so cool. The libraries are at our fingertips. You could get a YouTube video. There's some beautiful sacred geometries, which I'm going to put up now. That's the Metatron Cube. I believe in archangels. Not everyone does. I do. And that's the symbol of linking divine heaven and earth. And a lot of these symbols, they're in D.C. Just saying, someone knows something. In other places on the planet, everyone says, oh, it's artwork. It's energy. So if you're willing, for the next 2 or 3 minutes, and those of you at home, we're going to breathe. Or you can look at this symbol. Let's see if the Grand Creator has a message for you for today or this week. As you breathe in and out, feeling and sensing and knowing that we are all protected. That Gaia, Mother Earth, still supports and loves us. And the Divine Creator, known by name in our hands, that we are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the higher consciousness. We are the superheroes. That we are protected and guided by the oneness of the light and the truth of love for all. Amen.
as a boy, a certain strange, enchanted boy. They say he traveled very far, very far, over land and sea. A little shy and sad, but very wise was he. And then one magic day, he came my way. And as we spoke, just to love and be loved in return. There was a boy, a certain strange, enchanted boy. They say he traveled very far, very far, over land and sea. A little shy and sad of eye, but very wise was he. Magic day, he came my way, and as we spoke of many things, fools and kings, this he said to me, the greatest thing you'll ever learn is just to love and be loved in return.
Wow. Allison, thank you. Wow. Follow her. Amazing. Thank you for being here. Thank you. And now is the time of offering. Invite the ushers to come up, please. And your offering allows beautiful talent like Allison to be here, for the lights to be on, and dare I say, the toilets to be flushed. And knowing that everything will be returned and multiplied. There are many ways of giving, also online, to go to our website, healthlandcenter.org. And we also have a dip jar in the back. It's this amazing computer system that will take your debit or credit card, and it's $10 dips, and they will flash, reminds you of Vegas or going up to Black Hawk without the drive. And it's something that gives back energetically. And there's a QR code also on your program that you may scan also to give, and also give throughout the week if you feel called. And thank you for those who also give online. Thank you very much. Deeply appreciate it. And now, we're going to bless and know that everything comes back. The universe is filled with flow of divine light and love. So we all together will say, and let us affirm together, the universe provides all that I need and all that I give with great joy. I share my prosperity with the world, seeds for the world, helping to manifest. And so it is. Thank you. And now it's time for the prayers of the people. Something we do here differently. We're going to have two mic runners. They'll possibly hold the mic for you. The prayers of the people is something you have a prayer for yourself, and I encourage a prayer for yourself, or a prayer for a loved one. Please do not provide any last names. This is on YouTube and Facebook. We want to honor people's confidentiality. And I also request that you have requests to pray for other people. Some people are going through something, and sometimes they want to work it out in their way. So I believe we are to honor everyone's free will as the divine honors ours. And also, I believe in the KISS principle, keep it simply spiritual. If you need a longer amount of time with a prayer partner afterwards, Kiney, who is amazing, she will be here to provide a more in-depth prayer where you can be more personal about your prayer request. If anyone has a prayer.
This one's kind of selfish, but I did put an audition in for America's Got Talent, and I would just like prayers that I successfully get to participate.
Yay!
Thank you.
Yes, I would like a prayer for Laura, who's in the hospital, and they're trying to decide what direction to go, and what is wrong with her. So I would like a prayer for Laura.
Yes, I just wanted to thank you for all the prayers for my brother-in-law, Bill. About a week and a half ago, he was involved in a head-on collision, and now he's off all the tubes except for oxygen, and they're monitoring that. Had many internal injuries. And he's more aware, sitting up and starting some physical therapy. So very good. Thank you all.
Thank you.
I'd like to ask for some prayers for myself. I'm just doing a minor procedure tomorrow, doing the carpal tunnel release. And I did that in my right, and it really helps. And so feeling hopeful about that for some symptom relief. But being a mom, I use both my hands a lot, and so just some prayers that everything goes well and the day-to-day life is happening still with ease with one hand.
Happy Jewish New Year to everybody. Lashana Tova, Mazel Tov, Chag Sameach.
I'd like to ask a prayer for my wife, Judith. She's at home with vertigo, and I would like to ask for healing thoughts and healing prayers for her. Thank you.
Thank you. And know that they're all always already done. All prayers are always answered. Anyone online, feel free to email your prayer requests. And anyone here in the room that wasn't called to speak up, which is totally fine, email Althea, and they are prayed over and held in high consciousness and high watch. And now Luis, the wonderful Luis, for announcements. And please see Luis too, because we're always looking for volunteers. He's our amazing volunteer coordinator. He is amazing, a gift of heart.
Speaking of volunteers, we'll need some help today in the kitchen, cleaning up, sweeping, putting dishes away. So if you can stay after lunch, that would be well appreciated. All right, so we have our community connections still going on Thursdays from 11 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. And actually, I was going to preface this by saying, let's practice that super consciousness and see if you are called to any of these events and happenings, and practice that deep listening. Community connections from 11 a.m. to 12:30 Thursdays. We also have a book club going on right now, with Reverend Arika King facilitating the group. They meet on Thursdays from 2 to 3:30. And then also on Thursdays, we have yoga in the evenings with Linda. We are wrapping up 1 5-week cycle. So if you are interested, this Thursday would be the day to go. And then there will be a 2-week break, so you know. All right, our 100-year campaign is still chugging along. We are so close. We're this close. We have raised $73,000. So, yeah, abundance. Woo! All right, so the next goal is to finish off strong with $27,000. So if you have some of that money, or if you know somebody that might have deep pockets, let them know that we are looking to finish that off by the end of this year. All right, and then today in this space, it will be blessed by a gong bath. So you can be part of that too. It starts at 12:30, and if you can purchase a ticket at the door for $25. Okay, I think that's all I have. I hope something there stirred and is called to you, and you will join one of those as well. All right, thank you.
Morning. Where's Ricky? Ricky Stanton. I need Ricky for the community song. He might be in the kitchen, in the dining room. So, yeah, this morning our community song is kind of special. It's from a 70s TV show called Greatest American Hero. And Greatest American Hero was about an average guy who was made into a superhero, a very unlikely superhero. So, as soon as Ricky gets here, we'll go ahead and do Believe It or Not. Hey, there's Ricky. So please stand as you're able and find the superhero inside of you and join me in Believe It or Not. Look at what's happened to me. I can't believe it myself. Suddenly I'm up on top of the world. Should have been somebody else. Believe it or not, I'm walking on air. I never thought I could feel so free. Flying away on a wing and a prayer. Who could it be? Believe it or not, it's just me. Just like the light of a new day, it hit me from out of the blue. Breaking me out of the spell I was in, making all of my wishes come true. Believe it or not, I'm walking on air. I never thought I could feel so free. Flying away on a wing and a prayer.
Who could it be? Believe it or not, it's just me.
Thank you so much. And now, Bob.
Something wonderful is happening to me right now. It's that thing called life. I found my superhero cape. I got it on. I'm ready to fly. I know it. I feel it. And I am it. And so it is.